The dollar remains at risk despite the intensifying situation right now with US and China and, of course, Hong Kong. Now, remember yesterday, just a quick recap, the dollar was hit hard, okay? Very hard to the downside. It's a bearish day given the risk appetite seen in the market. So a lot of the riskier assets were bullish, outperforming the dollar. Just general underperformance for the greenback, just given the massive slowdown seen in sort of COVID-19 cases and the lack of evidence to show that there's going to, or sign that there's going to be a second wave. Of course, there's a lot of optimism for a strong economic rebound given all of this government easing we're seeing across Europe, the UK and Japan. So looking promising for a potential decent rebound in the second half of this year. Now, so overnight in Asian trading, the dollar staged a rebound, okay? And we saw that carry through slightly into this morning session, this morning European session, and that upside being seen. Why? Well, rhetoric continued to remain fiery with Trump this time, again, actually overnight, just saying that China are facing sanctions. We're sort of reviewing that at the moment, and there'll be an update in terms of details by the end of the week. China hit back and said, of course, anyone that tries to block their, basically their legislation, their security legislation that they're looking to pursue in Hong Kong at the moment, then they will retaliate, essentially. So it's very fiery. Protesting in Hong Kong is still being seen actually today, which is not good, but the markets are somewhat disregarding this for the time being. I think, yes, we saw that little bit of dollar, that dollar upside. Fundamentally, it made sense. Technically, it made sense as a small correction, small technical bounce. But given the way in which markets have set up the start of this week and laid those foundations, it seems like the riskier assets want to remain bullish. Okay, some further dollar underperformance, at least potentially carrying that through to the start of next month, which is actually next week, June. And same, we're seeing that downside still with the precious metal gold. Follow me on Twitter. Remember I said those, pointing out that downside was seen yesterday when we were up at around that sort of 17, 25, 26 area. And obviously the price has come right down and likely to challenge that 1700 mark, you know, imminently, just with the power of this risk appetite at the moment. Just markets literally sweeping under the rug this situation with US and China and Hong Kong for the time being. It's not to say that within a heartbeat that can't change, for sure, and it can. It just depends. I think that the markets are waiting to assess the you know, the severity of the US's actions or sanctions on China come the end of the week. Other than that, guys, you see all this fundamental and technical stuff, we do it every single day, making sense of it all, going hand in hand. Do not hesitate to go freaknetwork.io, click and become a member, and just see what we've got to offer in terms of the daily analysis that we provide our members, the value there, and I'm sure you'll be taking away a lot of it, learning and education, and pipping opportunities. Stay lit, let's get it.